Is SwiftUI the future? Is SwiftUI going to replace UIKit at all? Are you just starting out to learn SwiftUI, feeling insecure? Don't know where to start with SwiftUI? Well, today I'm going to share with you 6 things I wish I knew about SwiftUI when I started. Make sure that you smash that like button and let's get into it. So let's check out 6 things I wish I knew about SwiftUI when I started out. And if you want to learn even more, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call where I can talk a little bit more about SwiftUI. Go ahead and check it out. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, number one, it's all about data handling. From imperative to declarative mind shift, this is what I had to deal with turning from UIKit to SwiftUI. In UIKit, you always have this imperative mindset that you say, okay, this should look like this, this should have a frame like that, this is its action, and so forth. Do this part when this happens. But with SwiftUI, it's the other way around. It's kind of a really hard mind shift game where you have to do the imperative stuff. So you just declare your views, and basically, that's it. You declare, okay, this is how it should look like in broad. You don't set frames, you don't set, all of those actions or in particular cases of what the UI should behave like. It's imperative. So you just declare how the UI should look like, and then let SwiftUI take care of the rest. And of course, that also goes for the data handling. It is imperative data handling. So you are listening to changes. It's a whole nother thing. So go ahead, make sure that you know that the data handling is about imperative mode. So for example, you are listening to changes. Number two, SwiftUI is a DSL. Now what is a DSL? That is a domain-specific language. That means that it's actually built upon UIKit. It's kind of a syntactic sugar upon UIKit. It's built on top of UIKit, but it doesn't work like UIKit. It feels and it behaves reactively, which is really, really nice. It takes care of all the UI bugs that you might have if you were to build all of these things out in UIKit. Number three. In SwiftUI, everything is a view. Now, that is kind of counterintuitive. If you are coming from UIKit, you have UI views, and then you just subclass, and then you have UI buttons, UI switch, and all of that stuff. But in SwiftUI, everything is a view, even if it's called a color, or if it's called a button, or a horizontal stack, H stack, or anything else that you might think of. Even the view modifiers are returning views. Basically, everything is a view. This is a must know in SwiftUI. Number four, a view is just a recipe. This is why SwiftUI is so super fast. It's just a struct that is lightweight, and then you just give this recipe to SwiftUI, and then it will interpret it and it will lay out the UI really, really fast. This is really a step forward, a real big step forward from UIKit, where we have subclassing and we have all of these nested views, and it has their children, their parents, and it's really, really big. It's busy. It is convoluted. Now, not with SwiftUI, because everything is a view. We have our recipe, and it's super, super lightweight because they are structs. Okay, number five. Working in SwiftUI is much faster, but working in UIKit, it is still more versatile. Now, if you just put a project side by side and I would build it out in SwiftUI and then in UIKit, in SwiftUI, I would just build it out super, super fast according to how I would build it out in UIKit. In UIKit, you have to write a lot of code. You have to kind of know a lot of quirks that UIKit has. Of course, SwiftUI has also its quirks, but with SwiftUI, you can do so much more in a fraction of a time. Now, in UIKit, you can do even more, but here comes the number six. Apple is pushing SwiftUI really, really hard. Now, if Apple is doing something, it does it on purpose. And it looks like they are pushing SwiftUI because they don't want us to have that fine detailed, fine grained access to UIKit. They want to have all of these pre-built views that we can use. Of course, UIKit is also kind of a pre-built stuff that developers use to build out apps. Now, the next step here is, it seems like, SwiftUI. Now, if you did like this video, go ahead and check out my previous one about at state in SwiftUI and what mistakes junior developers make and, of course, you want to avoid. Go ahead and check it out. It's right over here.